Hi there, it's Susan Winter. Welcome to my channel. I'm a best-selling author and relationship expert here answering your questions about love and dating and romance. And today I have a really great question. The difference between breaking up and giving up. So, for those of you who are my subscribers, thank you so very much. And if you're new to this channel and you like what you hear today, please click the subscribe button and add the little bell for notifications. And that way you'll know whenever I have a new video. And you can write me with your video requests at susanwinter.net. Go to the last page where it says contact and then fill out the little box that says video request. And maybe I'll read yours on camera. Okay, so today we are starting with one from Bridget. So Bridget, thank you so much for this because I think so many of us belabor the decision that we find we must make. You're in a something-something. You don't know what it is. Or maybe you're a little bit invested and you kind of had forward traction. Your partner's not showing up. What are you to do? Are you giving up? Are you breaking up? All right, so let me begin. Bridget writes, could you please address breaking up versus giving up? Breaking up denotes there was an official relationship. Giving up could be when you tried and hoped a relationship would happen, sometimes for years, then realize it won't. It emotionally feels like a breakup loss, but there's no real relationship, so is handling it similar? Bridget, you've come across a number of statements here, and so first of all, let me validate a couple points. More and more nowadays, especially, people are finding themselves drawn to a person and involved to some degree. Maybe there's not a name for it, maybe they don't give you a label, maybe you don't really know what it is, they're in and out of your life, or maybe you're participating to some degree and they are giving you hope just by showing up and being present in your life and agreeing to see you. In your case, specifically, it sounds like you held on to somebody for a number of years, hoping that one day they would recognize your worth. Number one, to that point, yeah, if somebody doesn't recognize your worth right off the bat, your sticking around to prove it to them is really counterproductive. If you know your own worth, then you don't need to get it from somebody else, and you certainly don't have to sell yourself or hope, or as I talk about so often, wait on a maybe. So this is like a bad investment. And there's another aspect of this, and I write about this extensively, where hope is actually harmful. Look, we couldn't survive a day in this world if we didn't have hope, have dreams, and believe that something better is going to happen, that whatever we're doing, we can reach a higher point. So, of course, that translates into relationships. But hope can be harmful if we have invested, whether it has a label or not, but we have invested our hope into something that is not giving us back concrete evidence that our hope has been founded. So it's like investing in a stock where you like the name or the prospectus looked really nice and you just keep throwing money in and throwing money in. And you see it's going down, but you know, like, you're like, yeah, it'll rally, it'll come back. And you just keep in it. And then comes the part that I call the degenerate gambler, where you've been in there so long, you're actually ashamed to walk away because your investment is so great at this point. And therefore, your loss is equal to that degree of investment. Time, energy, hope, heartache, longing, dreams, romantic goals. So, what is the difference between a breakup and giving up? If you have waited and someone has not come around, you must move. If you are in something, friend with benefits, occasionally sleep with somebody. Maybe you're even in a relationship where you are seen as a couple, but you are not getting what you want and need. And you know that. And you have tried everything. then is it really giving up? Because giving up is still an active decision. So if you are making an active decision, that's a proactive move. You have chosen. You didn't just say, oh, I don't know what to do, I'll just give up. You tried everything. And you, especially Bridget, you gave it years, it seems, right? So at that point, we make an active choice. We choose to stop investing. We choose to stop investing in this person that hasn't given us back what we feel we'd like to experience. And so that's not giving up. It is making a choice. There are times that the best thing we can do for ourselves is to see it for what it is. There's nothing to be ashamed of. Once you see it and you acknowledge it, and you can play out the future, that no, the future's not going to change. You've given this enough time, it is what it is. No changes are happening. There's nothing other than to make the decision to leave. And then in that way, that's actually empowered. So I hope that that helps you. Susan Winter at susanwinter.net. If you want to check out my consultation programs, please come to the site. And by the way, I have to thank my friend Keith Myers, who has been continually telling me to get into crypto. Yes, I do accept crypto for my a la carte. It is an option. It is not the only form of payment. You can still pay me as you normally do. But for those of you that are into digital currency, yes, of course, this is fabulous. So I have that option now. And please tune into my show every Thursday if you get a chance, 2 p.m. Eastern for the live show. And if you don't, you can watch the replay. You can always write to me. Thank you so much. And if you prefer to listen to this, you can catch this show on iTunes. Oh, wait, do they still have iTunes? On iHeartRadio and Spotify, or however you listen to your streaming music. It's called The Susan Winter Show. Thank you, everyone, for joining me. Have a great week.